very simple example. So this is my database. How many transactions we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4 transactions I have. How many items I have? A, C, D, B, C. Totally how many items you have? A, B, C, D, E. 5 items I have. Fine. So how is it? I will start now. In the first step, what is it? First I have to check for frequent one item set. Then I will generate candidate 1. Then I will go for K plus 1, candidate 2, so on. So to find the candidate one means what? What are these candidates I have? A, B, C, D, E. So I will take the candidates item set names here as A. When I talk about C1, I will take only one element at a time. See, next time when I go for C2, I have 2 elements. Next time when I go for C3, I have 3 elements. So C1 talks about only one element at a time. So what are the elements I have now? A, B, C, D, E. So in the first scan means with respect to this database, what I am trying to do, how many times A is appearing, how many times B is appearing, how many times C is appearing individually, I am going to cross check that. Before I start doing that, I need to pick some threshold path. What is this threshold I will check? I know that, first let me finish this, then you will be able to set the threshold here. So let us see how many times A is appearing here. Check in this. First transaction A is appearing one time. Second, there is no A. Third one, it is there. Yeah. Second time, A is appearing. Fourth one, no. So how many times A is appearing? 2 times A is appearing. Same way, B you check. You should answer no. How many times B is appearing by here? First transaction, no. Second one time. Third one time. Fourth one time. So how many times B is appearing? 3 times. How about C? First time, second time, third time. Correct? How many times D is appearing? First time. That's all. In second, third, fourth transaction, D is not appearing at all. So D is appearing only one time. The last one, last element E, how many times it is appearing? First transaction, no. Second one, 1, 2, 3. 3 times E is appearing. So this is how you have scanned how many times these elements are appearing frequently in the transactions. Now you can observe here. One time you can see, 2 times, 3 times. So I can take minimum one time, let us ignore now. I'll set my threshold for an example. So support minimum, I am taking it as 2. Minimum, because I know that 3 also I can try. 2 also, like maximum is 3. Minimum is 1 in between. I am taking threshold value as 2. Fine. So what is it I will do with this concept? I will ignore. I will take, when I have taken the minimum support as 2. Now for the next step, what is it I will do? Whichever the element is appearing, either 2 times or more than 2 times, only I will consider that. So since D is appearing less than this threshold value, I'll remove that. In the pruning principle means what? I will ignore, I will remove the infrequent item. D is infrequent item when I check with respect to this threshold value. As it is appearing only one time, that means what? Frequently it is not appearing next time. So remove D. The next table, what is left out now? I'll take only these 4. For L1, L1 means what? L is what? Whichever frequently appearing only, I am considering that with respect to the threshold 2. With respect to threshold 2, I know that A is appearing twice, I will consider that. B is appearing more than 2, I will consider that. C is appearing more than 2, I will consider that. E is appearing more than 2, I will consider that. So which is the one you have left out with? Yeah, pruning means what? You have removed D. Since it is not appearing, the algorithm. This is a database given. Example, the transaction ID. I have 4 transaction we have. The items are A, C, D, B, C, A, B, C, E, B, E. So I have A, B, C, D, E, 5 elements. So item set, I have A, B, C, D, E. When I take individually, when I will take go for C1, candidate 1. So only one element is taken at a time. So I have A, B, C, D, E. So A is appearing frequently 2 times, 1, 2. Whereas B is appearing 3 times here, transaction 2, 3 and 4. And C is appearing 3 times here, 1, 2, 3, 5. Whereas D is appearing only one time, that is the first transaction. So D only one time. E is appearing how many times? 1, 2, 3. So this is what I will do in the first scan when I go for candidate 1. When I have only one element at a time. Fine. So based on these analysis, I have taken this, what is this? The minimum support as 2. Because I want to, in the pruning principle, I will remove the item which is infrequent. So is D is infrequent, it's appearing only one time. So next time it is not appearing, so I'll remove the D. So which are all left out? I am left out with A, B, C and E. A, B, C and E, and whatever the time they are appearing frequently, I have listed that. A is appearing twice, B three times, C is appearing three times, again E is appearing three times. So among these values, 2 and 3, 3 is the maximum and 2 is the minimum. So I've taken a threshold value, support value, minimum as 2 now. So next step, what is it I will do? When I go for C2, candidate 2. Now C2 means what is that I will do? I will go for 2 elements at a time. How is the 2 elements? I'll come back to this database. So in this table, from this table, I'll derive 2 elements at a time. How is that I will do? First time I'll take A with B, fine. Next time I'll take A with C, fine. Next time, what is that I will do? A with E, fine. Next I'll go for B combination. First, next I'll take B with C, correct? Next I will take B with E, correct? Next I will take C with E. So these are all the maximum combination I get. How is that you did? First one, A with B, then A with C and A with E. A is done. B you will start now. B with A is already done when I started doing A. So what is that I'll do? B with C is done and B with E is done. Then now C with B and A is already done. So C with E. So A, B, A, C, A, E, B, C, B, B, C. So these are the item set you have to consider when you go for candidate 2 generation. Now let us scan how many times A, B is appearing in the database. How many times A, C is appearing. All that I will check in the next table. So in the C2 second scan, I'll take these item set in the one of the column item sets as A, B, A, C, A, E, B, C, B, E and C. Let us see A, B how many times it is appearing in the database. First transaction, no. Second transaction, no. Third transaction, AB is appearing. That's all. Fourth transaction, no. So only one time AB is appearing, fine. Next, AC, how many times it is appearing? One time, second transaction, no. Third time, A and C is appearing, yes. Fourth one, no. Only twice AC is appearing. How about AE? First transaction, no. Second transaction, no. Third transaction, AE is appearing, yes. Fourth transaction, no. So AE is appearing only once. Come to BC now. BC, how many times it is appearing? First transaction, no. Second transaction, one time. Third transaction, second time. That's all. Fourth transaction, no. So BC is also appearing twice. How about BE? BE, first transaction, no. B is appearing. Next, second one, yes. B is appearing. Third one, yes. So one time, second time, third time. Thrice it is appearing. So how about CE? First transaction, no. Second transaction, yes. One time. Third transaction, yes. Second time. Fourth transaction, no. So C is appearing twice. So this is our first, you have scanned how many times these item sets are appearing. So when I look at this, what is that you are supposed to do now? I have to remove the infrequent. See, one I have taken as infrequent because next time it's not appearing only. Then why I will go with that? So I'll remove AB, I'll remove AE. Others I will check twice it is appearing. That means on minimum time. Minimum time it is appearing, AC. BC also minimum time. So support minimum it is appearing twice. And BE is appearing more than this. Yes, I will consider. C is appearing minimum time. So what are the things left out in the next step? So I have AB I have removed. AC I will take with two times. AE is removed. BC I will take with two times. Then B I will take with three times. Then C I will take with two times. So this I will continue because in this again I will find out which is more frequently appearing. Fine. So this is my L2. L2 means what? This L2, you have scanned the C2, how many times they are appearing. C2 means what? Two elements you have taken at a time. In these two items, which are all the items appearing more frequently, I have found it. So in this table, B is appearing more frequent. Fine. So what is the next step? C3. C3 means what? You have to go for three elements at a time. Here more analysis is not required because I know that among these four, which is appearing more frequently? B is appearing more frequently. Correct. Next time, when you talk about C3, when you talk about C2, obviously I'll go with two elements. Two times frequent appearance I have to consider. When I talk about three, so I have to go for three elements, then which is that appearing more time here in this? B is appearing more time. So obviously you can ignore AC, you can ignore BC, you can ignore CE. So when I talk about BE, I want to know which is the other element along with BE, third element is appearing more time. So I'll check. So I will take first what BE is the minimum thing you have to take. So minimum BE is appearing thrice, I know. So in this scan, you can check. You check with BE now. First transaction BE is there, no. Second transaction BE is there. along with C, it is appearing one time. I know that. Next, I will check whether BC is appearing any more time. Yes. Again, one more time, BC is appearing. Correct? Next, so two times you have already traced that BC is appearing. Right? When I check for the last transaction, B is appearing, but C is not there. What is it I am trying to do now? Along with B, I am trying to find third element which is appearing more time. So I have B in only three steps, only three transactions, second, third and fourth. I have B here in the second transaction, B here in the third transaction, B in the fourth transaction. But fourth transaction I have to ignore because there is no third element at all. So only second and third transaction you can find the third B along with B, I can find third element as C appearing twice. So BC is appearing once in the second transaction and BC is appearing the second time in the third transaction. So I'll go with the item set in the candidate 3 as BCE, the third scan, to find out L3. L3 means what? Which are the three elements frequently appearing? BC is appearing frequently. How many times? The frequent number of times is 2. So this is my result.